cultural harmony, to nurture cultural harmony, we need to exhibit love. Love, grace, and mercy. Let me ask you, how many of you really know your neighbor? If someone moved into your neighborhood, would you be willing to just go and say, hey, we see you moved in, we're available to help you? How many of you actually know your neighbor to the right and your neighbor to the left? Love is time, T-I-M-E. Families spend a lot of time with their children. Teachers spend a lot of time with their students. Churches spend a lot of time with their members. So to nurture cultural harmony, we need to not only know that we're special and others are special, we need to not only know that we treat others with dignity and respect, but we need to show love, grace, and mercy to all. Because it's all about others. And so as I leave, I want to share a poem that is my motto, Others, by Charles Banks. It goes something like this. Lord, let me live from day to day in such a self-forgetful way that even when I kneel to pray, my prayer will be for others. Help me in all the work I do to ever be sincere and true, and know that what I do for you must needs be done for others. Oh Lord, when I've done the best I can, and heaven is now with me, God, and I've won so many crowns, may I forget the crowns that I've won, while thinking still of others. Others, Lord, yes, others, let this my motto be, help me to live for others, that I might live like thee. So to nurture cultural harmony, as I challenge you in 2016, let us truly understand that we are special, and those we come in contact with are special. Help us to understand to treat others with dignity and respect. And finally, to nurture cultural harmony, let us exhibit love, grace, and mercy. May God bless you, and may God keep you. Thank you.
The concept of inoculation against disease was introduced in the United States by a slave named Onesimus. He told Puritan Mr. Cotton Mather about the centuries-old African tradition of extracting material from an infected person and scratching it into the skin of an uninfected person to make them immune. The procedure was first tried in Boston in 1721 during the smallpox epidemic and later during the Revolutionary War to inoculate soldiers. Thank you.
Our final speaker is Chauncey Newell.
I'm not unmindful that some of you have come here after great trials and tribulations. Some of you have come fresh from never jail cells, and others have come from areas where your quest for freedom have left you battered by the storms of persecution and staggered by the winds of police brutality. You are veterans of creative suffering. Continue to work with the faith that unearned suffering is redemptive. Go back to Mississippi. Go back to Georgia. Go back to Louisiana. Go back to South Carolina. Go back to the ghettos and slums of the northern cities, knowing that somehow this situation can and will be changed. Let us not wallow in the valley of despair. I say to you today, my friends, so even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal. Now I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at a table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of oppression, sweltering with the heat of injustice, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that one day my four little children will grow up in a nation where they would not be judged on the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day, down in Alabama, with this vicious governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and notification. Right there in Alabama, little black boys and little black girls will be able to join hands together with little white boys and little white girls. That's sisters and brothers. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted. Every hill and mountain shall be made alone. The rough places become plain and the crooked places become straight. And the glory of the Lord shall reveal itself and all of God's flesh shall see it together. This is our hope and this is our faith that I go back to the South with this faith. We'll be able to transform the mountain of despair into a stone of hope. With this faith, we'll be able to transform the journey and discourse of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we'll be able to pray together, to work together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that someday we will be free. But this will be the day. This will be the day when all of God's children sing with a new meaning, my country, 'tis of thee. Sweet land of liberty, for thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrims cry. From every mountainside, let freedom ring. And if America is to be a great nation, this must become true. And so let freedom ring from the hilltops of New Hampshire. Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains of New York. Let freedom ring from the high Alleghenies of Pennsylvania. Let freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado. Let freedom ring from the vivacious slopes of California, but not only that. Let freedom ring from the stone mountain of Georgia. Let freedom ring from the mountain of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from every hill and molehill of Mississippi, from every mountainside. Let freedom ring. And when this happens, when we allow freedom to ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, to every state, to every city, we'll be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, we'll be able to sit down and join hands and sing the words of the old Negro spiritual. Free at last, thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Warren Jack, the CEO of Jack Piano, the keyboard, is the first African-American piano manufacturer in the world. A Washington, D.C. area native and Howard University graduate, he was a child prodigy drummer who played his first concert at the age of 4. Chad is also the inventor of the interactive Chad Piano, a high-tech piece of hardware that allows for distance learning and other innovative pieces. Thank you.
It's believed that the iconic Lone Ranger of Western stories was originally inspired by an African-American named Bass Reeves. Reeves was born a slave, but he escaped west after the Civil War and eventually became a deputy U.S. Marshal. He was the master of disguise, an expert marksman, and rode a silver horse. However, this story was not unique. At least 25% of Western cowboys were actually African-Americans.
Bessie Coleman was born in 1892 in Atlanta, Texas. She grew up in the middle of harsh poverty, discrimination, and segregation. Her dream of aviation led her to Chicago and then to France. In 1921, she received an international pilot license, becoming the first African-American female pilot. Thank you.
Charles Bolton Jr. graduated from the U.S. Naval Academy, flew over 100 missions as Navy and Marine Corps, with 4 space missions with NASA as an astronaut. He retired as a Major General for the Marines in 2004. In 2009, he became NASA's first African-American administrator.
Born in Atlanta, Georgia, Karen Newton is the second of 3 boys. His parents stressed and supported hardworking academic and athletics. He was highly recruited in high school but had to overcome injuries and allegations in college. He led and won the Heisman Award Trophy in 2010, and he was also the first pick of the NFL Draft in 2011. And he almost led the Carolina Panthers to a perfect season last year. At the age of 26, Cameron Newton is the 3rd African-American quarterback to play in the Super Bowl and the 1st African-American quarterback to win the NFL's MVP award. Thank you.